Welcome to MISUMI's new 19-minute webinar series. For those of you here that are new to MISUMI, MISUMI is a global supplier of configurable components. You may ask, why configurable? What is it? Configurable components solve the designer's dilemma. A designer has two choices for components, standard or custom. Standard components have limited selection and often force designers to compromise their designs. These many pluses, such as CAD, static part numbers, fast delivery, often seem inexpensive and convenient. The other choice is custom. Custom components have many drawbacks. Designers have to make the solid models themselves in all the manufacturing drawings. Purchasers too can attest to the long wait for quotes, the expensive setup charges for short runs, and the long lead times. We are forced to use custom components though, because of the flexibility. MISUMI offers configurable, which is the best of both, easy and flexible. Configurable components are easy to design with and purchase. Online, select the product geometry desired, the material and surface finish. Input the size for each configurable dimension within the range and increment shown. You'll get a smart part number, instant price and days to ship, and the CAD model. All of this configurability is available with our over 1 million components, available at MISUMIUSA.com. Now, I'll turn it over to our MISUMI engineer.
Hi, my name is Vince Chan. I'm a product engineer for standard components. In this webinar, I will introduce to you an actuation component called ball screw. What are ball screws? They are another kind of mechanical actuators that can translate rotary motion into linear motion. The ball screw is made up by a rotating screw shaft and a ball nut. The ball nut is a sub-assembly consisting of recirculating ball bearings. The bearings roll in and out of the nut, then along the grooves, which minimizes the friction of the motion. Motion follows the same principle as the bolt and nut. As the shaft rotates, the nut moves linearly along the screw shaft. The ball nut has a flange. The flange is for mounting brackets, and it will typically face the fixed side of the shaft. Ball screws are essential components for linear motion systems, such as motor-driven actuators, often found in precision applications. However, ball screws are not the only components that can convert rotary motion into linear motion. There are also belts and pulleys, gears and gear racks, or lead screw nut assembly. This last in particular also follow the principle of the bolt and nut. Therefore, why use ball screws? Because they offer several advantages, one of which is low friction. Compared with lead screws that have high friction loss, the rolling coefficient of friction for ball screw is as low as 0.002. As a result, high energy efficiency can be achieved, and virtually no stick slip would occur. They're accurate and precise. Their accuracies can be 12 microns or less within the target displacement. The accuracies of MISUMI ball screws are controlled by the Japanese Industrial Standard, abbreviated as the JIS. Ball screws have little to no backlash. Backlash is a term for lost motions caused by gaps between mechanical parts. It can negatively affect the repeatability of the travel. Because ball screws can be preloaded to high rigidity, they can achieve practically zero backlash. Last but not least, they are high-quality products. Each individual component is hardened to at least 56 Rockwell C, by induction or by carburization. The ball screw nut works by recirculating bearings that roll along the grooves of the shaft. There are four basic types. In the first method, bearings are recirculated through the end cap on each end of the nut. This type performs well at high-speed operations. The second method embeds deflectors on the inside of the nut to return the balls over the screw shaft. This method is suitable for compact designs. The third type uses return tubes mounted on the outside of the nut to recirculate the bearings. This is an easy-to-assemble method suitable for mass productions. The last method uses guide plates instead of return tubes for recirculation. The advantage here is also compact design. There is not a standard method. The recirculation type depends on the specification of the ball nut. For example, larger standard nuts may have return tubes, while smaller compact nuts may use deflectors. Ball screws achieve high rigidity and repeatability through preloading. There are three common ways. The first way is to create a constant force by using bearings that are slightly larger than the size of the grooves. The second way is to use a spacer between a set of nut with thickness precisely machined to achieve the desired preload. And in the third method, it utilizes a spring and double nut configuration. The precision class ball screws are typically preloaded and therefore have much finer repeatability than non-precision classes. MISUMI ball screws are made according to the JIS Accuracy Classes. It is one of the standards that define the accuracies of the ball screw. The accuracy class is denoted by the letter C, followed by a number representing the accuracy grade. The smallest C number that can start with is 0. As the C number increases, the accuracy decreases. For example, C0 is more accurate than C3, C3 is more accurate than C5, and so on. The lower the accuracy, the greater the error to be expected. The choice of accuracy class depends on the application. For example, an industrial precision robot may require C3, while a woodworking machine may be sufficient with C7 or C10. When selecting ball screws, you must know that for a given distance of travel, what amount of deviation would you tolerate? The accuracy class defines the expected errors for the ball screw. There are four major values that the JIS controls. EP is the mean difference between the intended travel and the actual travel. VU, the range of variations over the actual travel. V2π is the variation of the actual travel from an arbitrary full revolution. And V300 is the variations from the actual travel from an arbitrary 300 millimeter span. To show you an example of the difference in accuracy going from one class to another, compare between the C3 and the C5 ball screw in this table. At a length of 800 millimeters, the C5 exhibits 17 microns more error in the actual mean travel, and 12 microns more error in the travel variations. In general, the amount of errors to be expected is about twice more in C5 than C3. MISUMI offers two precision grades of ball screws. They are the precision ground and the roll ball screws. The precision ground have JIS classes of C3, C5, and C7, while the roll types have C7 and C10. As you can see, the precision ground has higher accuracy. The difference between the precision ground and the roll screw is that, on the precision grade, the grooves are finished by machine grinding, whereas on the roll grade, the grooves are corroded. The first method ensures precise concentricity with the ball thread. In addition, the precision ball screws are preloaded to ensure high repeatability. The choice of precision grade is dependent on the application. Suppose you have an application where you need to position a mass anywhere along a given distance. Some of the important constraints are speed, accuracy, repeatability, design life, and motor speed. The values listed here are examples for demonstration purpose only. The ball screw will be mounted to a motor on the fixed end, while simply supported on the other end. This is a general guideline to selecting the ball screw. First, calculate the lead, then the minimum dynamic load rating, and then finally the total length. Step 1, calculate the lead. A lead is defined as the displacement of the ball nut in one rotation. The lead can be calculated by dividing the speed, Vmax, by the maximum motor revolution, Nmax. In the example given, the minimum lead required is 20 millimeters. Step 2. Find the minimum load rating. There are two load ratings, the dynamic load and the static load. The static load is the maximum allowable load while in steady state. On the other hand, selecting the dynamic load rating is more involved. The dynamic low rating is an accumulative low value that has accounted for the dynamic forces of the motion. It is defined where 90% of the ball screw will last at least 1 million rotations without wear of the rolling surfaces. The dynamic low rating, C, can be calculated as a function of the operating life, LH, mean rotation rate, NM, mean axial load, PM, and the work factor, FW. This last parameter accounts for sudden impacts in operation. It ranges from 1 to 2, from no shocks to frequent impacts. Let us assume a work factor of 1.2 for this example. But in order to acquire the three remaining variables, you must know the motion profile of the application. An example of motion profile would be a graph of velocity versus time. From it, you can extract the velocities and accelerations at various durations of the cycle. Using this information in conjunction with formulas available in the data section of the catalog, you can calculate the mean axial load, mean rotation frequency, and actual operating life. The actual operating life may not be the same as the design life. Calculate the actual based on the fraction of the cycle when the unit is actually in motion. Once you have determined the required variables, PM, NM, LH, and work factor, plug them into the dynamic load formula to calculate the minimum dynamic load rating required for the ball screw. In the example given, I have calculated 3,700 newtons. If you would like to be more conservative, you can always adjust the individual variables. In the last step, calculate the total length. It is not simply the stroke. It also includes the length of the ball screw nut, shaft end lengths, and an allowable margin of travel at either end of the stroke. Be sure to review the catalog drawings to determine the total length you need. Accounting for all of these parameters, our example would need a minimum of 914 millimeters. At this point, you should have all information needed, namely the lead, dynamic low rating, total length of the shaft, and the accuracy and repeatability for the application. As you browse through the MISUMI catalog, you will find that the BSS product type meet or exceed all of the requirements specified by this example. If you check the accuracy of the C5 class ball screw, you will see that it falls well within the requirements of 50 micron accuracy. You can begin generating a part number from this selection. MISUMI ball screw part numbers are coded based on material, shaft diameter, lead, and configurable length. In this example, we have BSS 1520 -914. MISUMI catalog offers three types of ball screw nuts. They are the standard nut, block nut, and compact nut. The compact nut is unique in that it can have up to 40% reduction in volume compared to standard ball nuts. As a result, you can design lower profile units, but because of reduced volume, they will recirculate less ball bearings and therefore have smaller low ratings. Not every grade of accuracy and precision is available for each type. Grades C3 through C10 are all available for the standard type in both row and precision grades. The block type is available in C10 row grade. The compact nut is available in C3 and C10 accuracies in both precision grades. Be sure to check the MISUMI website for the latest product availability. MISUMI offers configurable dimensions to the ball screw shaft. In this drawing, all the dimensions in blue, namely the shaft length, end diameters, and end lengths, are all configurable in 1 mm increments. In addition to standard configurations, several alterations are available. Alterations are optional changes to the unit such that it may ease the installation of the ball screw shaft. To name a few, these include reversing the direction of the ball screw nut so that the flange will face the opposite end of the shaft, ordering without retaining ring groove, adding wrench flats, adding keyways, installing a temporary shaft to the ball screw nut so that additional machining can be done prior to installation, or ordering the shaft without any standard machining. Also available in the catalog are a variety of accessories that will ease your search of components. There are various bearing support units for both the fixed side and the support side. You will also find peripheral accessories such as nut stoppers, nut brackets, and joint units for AC servo motors. Be sure to check the online catalog for the latest components. Please keep in mind that these products are very high quality and competitively priced. In-stock items are shipped the same day, while non-stock items are shipped in a minimum of 4 days. MISUMI ball screws are initially filled with lithium soap grease. You may need a different grease due to environmental constraints. The first alternative available is an L-type ether synthetic grease for high temperature operations. The second option available is the G-type mineral grease for clean rooms that require minimal particle dispersion. When contaminated with dust, ball screw accuracy can diminish. It is recommended to re-grease every 6 months or every 1,000 kilometers. Some ball screw nuts have oil access ports, allowing you to directly apply the grease. However, for those without the oil access port, apply the grease to the shaft grooves, then rotate the nut back along the shaft. In general, proper selection and maintenance will ensure long life and accurate performance of the ball screw. Let us go to the MISUMI USA website and practice selecting a ball screw using the online configurator. Here is the MISUMI homepage. It is divided into 3 sections: automation, press die, and plastic mold. We will focus on automation components. In this page, you can browse the major categories via the left panel or the pictorial indexes on the right. Under the linear motion category, find and click on ball screw. Here, you can narrow down your search using the filter on the left, or you can browse through the list on the right. For this example, I will select in the filter column 20mm lead, 15mm OD, and C5 precision. Now there is only one option to select. I click on it, and the site redirects me to the details page. In the filter, I will select the only options available to me. Then I will manually type in the length of the shaft. For the grease type, I will go with standard. Since all necessary values have been entered, the site automatically generated the part number. To view the alterations available for this part, scroll to the bottom of the main page. To enter the alterations, scroll down in the filter section. For now, we're skipping the alterations. To find the compatible support units for this part, click on the More Information tab, and you will find the recommended support units or any applicable accessories. This concludes our online presentation.
Thank you, and we hope you enjoyed today's webinar. All of MISUMI's configurable components and 1 million products are available at www.misumiusa.com. If you are new to MISUMI, register for access to CAD downloads, online formal quotes and orders, and manage all of your account histories. For first-time companies purchasing, you can receive 30% off. Full support is also available. Technical help at engineering@misumiusa.com, customer service at inquire, and your local account manager at sales. Facebook now has our 19-minute video series available to view at your leisure. Connect with us to join the conversation and see exclusive content. Thank you again.